Yankee Stadium, it's Army against the Air Force, with Air Force Secretary Douglas and Chief of Staff General White among the 68,000 cheering the inaugural of a new service classic. Falcons lead by six, and Glenn Blumhardt takes Caldwell's pass to put Army back in the fray. Bob Anderson drives off tackle to gain 7 yards for the cadets as the quarter ends. Playing with a leg injury, Anderson plows across for the TD, and Army goes into the lead 7-6. Towards the end of the half, Anderson plunges over the goal line again, and Army heads the Falcons 13-6. In the final quarter, Joe Caldwell passes to Don Usery. It's a fumble, and John Baucom grabs it for the Air Force on the Cadets 30. On fourth down, the Falcons' Rich Mayo rolls out and fires a pass to Quickie for a first down. 2 plays later, Mike Quinlan streaks wide around right end to score, and the Falcons tie it up in the closing minutes. It's a thrilling beginning for a new gridiron tradition as the Falcons race the clock with another scoring threat. But the kick by Pupik is wide of the goalposts. The game ends 13-all with glory aplenty for both sides. At Baton Rouge, a clash of titans, LSU and Mississippi, both unbeaten and untied. 67,500 see Charlie Plowers ram off right tackle. Ole Miss first down on the 8. LSU's famous Chinese bandits on defense bounce Jake Gibbs back on an attempted rollout. So on fourth down, Bob Kayett boots one to split the goalposts at 22 yards. Mississippi leads 3-0. Mississippi leads into the fourth quarter, but the Tigers' defense is still savage. The Rebels can't get rolling again, and the score stays 3-0. Ole Miss punts. Gibbs kicks deep into Tiger territory. All-American Billy Cannon takes it on the 11 and runs a gauntlet of Mississippi tacklers. Frank Merriwell all the way, 90 yards to the paydirt. Louisiana State topples Mississippi 7-3 to keep its number one gridiron rank.